गुड मॉर्निंग इंग्लिश लिटरेचर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग द पोइट्री रिटन बाय रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, दैट इज़ वे द माइंड इज़ विदाउट फेयर. स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, ही इज़ द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू रिसीव द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर हिज राइटिंग्स. गीतांजलि द बुक विच for with the book which he won the award Nobel Prize in 1913. Students, actually this poem was originally written in Bengali language, and Rabindranath Tagore was a versatile genius. He was not only a playwright, he was also a poet, and he himself got it translated from Bengali to English. And you know, his contribution to literature is immense, and reading his few lines get you inspired. So you get whenever you read his poems, it's not only you see the mixture of Indian culture, Western culture, so that is very remarkable. Now, just to actually, I have already given you the notes, and just to read out about him. He was an Indian poet born in 1861, and that was in Calcutta. He was and is the foremost poet in Bengali language, and was also versed in short story, play and essay writer, as well as painting and composing music. He started writing poetry early, and throughout his life he would publish several books as well as complete collection of his work. In 1913 he became the first Indian to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. So I told you his goal was to blend the best of Indian and Western poetry. So you know, he was much ahead his times. So that is what is very remarkable about him. Now, when you see the goal, when you read this poem, see the title itself, Where the Mind is Without Fear. So generally this poem is having a, what do you say, you know, universal approach, and till today you can, you know, relate it to many contexts. Like, he is writing when the India was not independent, we were still having the shackles, we were under the British rule. But this particular poem also deals with the liberation of liberation of the mind, you know, which is in the clutches of what you say, in the modern, what you say, thought which really mars your, what you say, creativity, etc., etc. So just, I have taken this from Wikipedia. I'll just read out the editorial note. Where the Mind is Without Fear by Rabindranath Tagore is one of his vastly read and discussed poems. It was originally composed in Bengali and possibly in 1900 under the title Prarthana, meaning prayer. It appeared in the volume called Nebedya in 1901. Later, as I told you, in 1911, Tagore himself translated the Bengali poem into English, and that translation appeared as poem 35 in his Nobel-winning anthology, Gitanjali. Gitanjali is the song offerings, and it's a very small, thin book, but it comprises, you know, lot of matter. Now, it was published by the Indian Society, London, in 1912. So students, I will just be, first of all, it's just 11 line poem. I'll just be reading this short lyric, and then we will discuss this lyric. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arm towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. Now, see the first line of the poem, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. And how does he conclude? Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. So when this poem was written, our country was under the British rule. And he wanted his countrymen, he knew that freedom is coming, but he wanted his countrymen to be free, not only from the clutches of the British rulers, but also from the narrow walls of their own thinking. Okay, so that is very, very remarkable. And you can have volumes, volumes written on this particular poem. Now see the first line. Where the mind is without fear. So he wants a country where people are without fear. So see, if we see it in a modern context, we people are always living in fear. So why fear? Because you are not enlightened. That is the fear. You are fearing your own self, your own mind. But your self, which is, inner self, it can see my mind is in trouble. Okay, so why? You are the one who can see that what is taking place, what is happening to my body, what is happening to my mind. Then why having fear? So let me have the freedom. Now here also the freedom of, freedom of your intelligence, freedom to realize that I am not this particular mind, this particular body, I am much above that. So there is no fear. But here if you see physically also, he is reminding his countrymen that why you are living in, because he wanted to remind the Indians that they are highly superstitious. Sorry. He wanted to remind them that they are not, having the knowledge, and they are not utilizing their knowledge. They are still living in the superstitious, they are having superstitious mind. They still don't believe in equality. People still fear everything. So this is what he wanted to remind people, that you can be free from British rule, but can you be free from yourself? Can you be free from your, narrow thinking? Okay, so that is the main, concept. He wants to awaken that in people. Okay, so this particular poem, it's a very remarkable poem. It can be, it's written in such lucid and such easy style that even the students of fifth standard, they can understand the main idea. And it's not only meant for the school-going students, but even the students, the college students, they can do research on this. So this is very important. Now, so he says, I want such a country where, the mind is without fear. So he basically believes in the idea of fearless mind. See, when are we fearless? As Gandhiji, the father of our nation, he says we can be fearless, if we are truthful. We can be fearless if we believe in the concept of love. We believe in the concept of brotherhood. We believe in the world of equality. So this is what. So our fearlessness comes from our self-confidence. Our fearlessness comes from from the values which are inherent. Okay, it comes from our, values of life. That is the most important thing. So you can hold your health, you can hold your head high if you are having that knowledge. Knowledge doesn't mean here only the bookish knowledge, but how do you implement it in your own life? Okay, so this is what is the main thing. Where the world, now see, he is today in the 21st century, the era of globalization, you can also connect it here. He says, where the world has not been broken up into fragments. Okay, so today's world, we are much more connected. Today, what is happening in Russia, what is happening in America, or what is happening in Japan. So, we just come to know at the instant. A thing happens there, any situation, any incident. Here, we are connected and we come to know. So, here he means to say, it is not only for my countrymen that I believe in such, what you say, fearlessness, but I also want that people, you know, the nations and nations, world wars took place because nation had what you say fear and grudge against another nation. So he says this should not be there. We must, you know, he says where the world has not been broken up into fragments, it is not being divided by narrow domestic walls where words come out from the depth of truth. That means you believe in truth, you believe in knowledge, you believe in equality, you believe in love. Okay, so that is what you believe in, non-violence. So this is what, where the tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. So here it's also, I feel, it's very rich in figures of speech. All natural images are there and you can feel alliteration, dreary desert sand of dead habit. Now dreary desert, it stands for lifeless desert, you know, where you find hardly any water, hardly any shade. So he says that our reasoning, we must never, you know, even if today we are, today you see in 21st century, we are not being, you know, slaves of any like British rulers, but still people are slave of their own thoughts, of their own narrow thinking. So he wants that we should not get lost, you know, where there is no stream in dreary desert. So we must have the clear stream of reason in our, what you say, in ourselves. So that is the most important thing, the message he wants to give to the youngsters. Okay, so we have to have independence of our own. That is what he says now. So that you have to keep intact, and that will give you the real strength. So where the mind is led forward by thee, thee stands for the common man, you know. It can be any, what you say, boy, any girl, any old man, any young man, that's what. So, into ever-widening thought and action. So, even thought and action, it must be widening. That means it has to encompass, it has to spread, this goodness has to spread into that heaven of freedom, my Father. So he says, O Lord, O God, let my country awake. So he not only wants to awaken them that we are still under the shackles of the British rule, but your mind, it should also be shackle free. So that is the main aim of the poet. That is why he is, you know, till today, the appropriateness of the poem, whenever you read it, you can derive a new meaning out of it. And, you know, that is the charm of this poem. And that is why this particular poem, it has been discussed so widely. Okay. So students, I end my lecture here for today. Thank you for your patience, student. Thank you so much.